गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, कैन यू हियर मी?
ओके, यस, दे कैन
यस
हियर.
सर. ओके, कैन यू सी माय स्क्रीन आल्सो? ओके,
यप.
थैंक यू. Myself Manish Koria welcomes you all for today's webinar on continuous monitoring with application insight. So we will start with our introduction about today's session. Before moving ahead into our webinar, I would like to introduce Synergetics Learning. Synergetics caters to a very niche segment of corporate solutions and learning, IT learnings. It offers IT technology solutions to organizations, companies, and enterprises, along with the training their IT teams in implementing and operating these solutions so that they stay ahead of the competition. Apart from group trainings, we are specialized in providing training for Microsoft certification and ensure every IT professional excels in today's competitive IT world. Presenting a brief overview of master solutions of Synergetics. Onboarding solution. Next is reskilling solution. Microsoft certification. Certification plus add-on technologies. Cloud adoption. Architecting workshops. Practice playbook, latest technology training, and last emerging technology training. Today's webinar is organized by ETC community and sponsored by Synergetics. Our ETC community is open for all people who are interested in emerging technologies and Microsoft cloud technologies. You just need to follow our meetup groups, which is Emerging Technology Community Mumbai, Emerging Technology Community Pune for Pune guys, Azure Tech Community Nagpur for Nagpur girls, Azure Tech Community Surat for Surat guys, and AI on Microsoft Platform Community. This community for who are interested in AI technology. You need to just install Meetup app on your phone and follow our communities so you will be updated about our events, meetups, webinars, and live workshops. This is our small code of conduct which you all need to follow. Please note that you can't take screenshot of the presentation, can't do screen recording. If you need recording, then simply subscribe our YouTube channel. We will share YouTube channel link in chat box later. Today I want to share an important message with you all. Recently there was an incident happened during our webinar. There was an attendee who are also an employee of well reputed company had contacted some other attendees and offered a job options. Guys, please take a note of this. We have already blacklisted this person, and if anything that will be violating our policies, will be facing strict legal actions from this time onwards. I will request you all to join our sessions with a learning purpose, and please do not make such activities which are unprofessional. Today's session is all about our continuous monitoring and application insight. Agenda for today's session is overview of continuous monitoring, monitoring servers and applications, monitoring applications with application insights, setting up application insights for Azure web apps, using Azure Application Insights SDK in application code, collecting logs and metrics, applications insight dashboard. Today's speaker for the webinar is Mr. Om Prakash, as you know already. Mr. Om Prakash is highly experienced Microsoft certified trainer with decades of rich experience in technical learning and implementation consultations across India and globe. His teaching experience span across more than 50,000 students and 200 enterprises around the world. Currently, he is working with Synergetics as an AVP of delivery department. Now you can grow professionally by adding the latest technology skills with Microsoft various certifications. You can enroll for any of these training programs with Synergetics, where you will be experiencing live interactive sessions with the best industry Microsoft certified trainers. Trust us, we will deliver the best. Our course calendar for the month. If you are interested of any of these trainings, please do contact me. Here you will get training along with the MOC and exam vouchers. Here you can see our latest and updated training programs. You can send us your inquiry on WhatsApp or call us. Number is shared in chat box later. So save it for future interaction with us. This is our webinar series calendar for the year. We have multiple emerging technology webinars in 2021 and 22. Our next webinar is on the BLED framework for Java web development. It is on 7th August, 10 a.m. So do register for this. Our next webinar is on Jakarta EE, specifications for NoSQL integration and designing enterprise web services. So please do register for these webinars. Webinar registration link in chat box. Please note your feedback is important to us. Again, we will sharing feedback form link in chat box later. So do please fill the feedback form. Now I would like to hand over the mic to Mr. Om Prakash. Thank you everyone once again. Om Prakash sir, you can proceed with your session.
Thank you very much, Manish. Hello and good morning, everyone. I hope I'm audible to you all.
Yes, sir. Good morning, sir.
Thank you very much.
Good morning.
Good morning. Is my screen visible to you all?
Yes, it is visible.
Yes.
Thank you. And warm welcome to all of you all. Thank you very much. I know throughout the week you all have been working and it has been very, very difficult for people working from home, where every organization feels that the employee is available 24/7, 365. I am also part of the same, so I can understand your situation. But even in that tough scenario, making sure you all are able to sneak out time to learn new technologies, make sure you are updated on what is happening in the industry. I'm pretty sure each of you all want to find out answers for their problems, apply these things on your day-to-day projects that you are working on, right? I will try my best to make sure I address all the questions in this session in the scope of continuous monitoring using Azure App Insights. So thank you once again for joining in. With this note, let's get started. My team, Manish and Rupesh, they will be active on the chat window. So any questions in terms of pricing, about other courses, about any other information that you all need, right? Non-technical details, you all can ask them. Put them on the chat window. Technical details, you can unmute yourself and ask questions directly to me. Okay. So with this note, let's get started. My name is Om Prakash Pandey. Like Manish already spoke about some things about myself. One thing he missed out and I want to add, I am passionate about training on new technologies, right? And I take every possible opportunity to make sure I upgrade myself and make sure share that information with maximum audiences. So moving ahead with this, whatever agenda is being mentioned, I will stick to the agenda because this topic is pretty vast and completing or touching upon on all the areas will not be possible in 2 hours. But such good journey to begin with, right? I will be sharing set of resources with you all so you all can start learning on it. Plenty of these details are available as part of Microsoft Azure documentation as well, where you all can take a look. As part of your day-to-day work life that we are going through, especially if you are connected to IT in any context, any role that you might be playing, everyone has to go through this loop. Now, what loop am I talking about? The loop over here is making sure that we communicate with the customers, and based on the customer's input being given, based on their requirements being shared with us, what we need to do as a team, as bunch of stakeholders, we will have to understand those requirements, gather those requirements, start building applications focused on that. Once you have built the applications, you'll have to make sure all the use cases which was asked by the customer is those issues are being resolved, is addressed by the solution, the project that you have created, the product that you're developing, right? It has to address that concern. And how do we come to know whether all those concerns are being addressed? That would obviously happen via testing. So customer requirement gathering being done, project being built by the development team. Development team also is doing the unit testing. Along with that, testing team is doing the black box, white box testing, automated testing, right? Checking for various use cases are being met or not by using test two, test cases, right? Now, once that part is being done, again, it will go back to the implementation, right? Again, the project has to be built by the operation team, and this cycle keep continues. And that's why we name this as continuous process, whether it is continuous requirement gathering, continuous development, continuous integration, continuous deployment, right? Everything over here is continuous, whether you're talking about CI/CD pipelines, right? Continuous delivery. Now, one of the most important things that you also have to understand is continuous feedback. So whenever we implement some of these things, right, we need to have continuous feedback. And for continuous feedback, we'll have to do continuous monitoring. Gone are the days when you have a restricted environment and only few people accessing that contents. Today, you have millions and trillions of users which could be accessing your application depending upon what services you are offering. Right? With cloud in picture, with the enormous services that you have, service providers, cloud providers who are giving you global reach, right? You can easily reach out to masses within, I would say, within few hours, not even days, right? That's a kind of scale which cloud allows you to go through. Now, keeping that context in mind, continuous monitoring, continuous feedback becomes very, very important for us. So if you look at continuous monitoring, what is involved in this? And what will be the key pillars that everybody has to understand when you are looking at your cloud-based migration? I'm sorry, guys. I am skipping out some of the things like cloud fundamental. I'm assuming some of the things that everybody is aware about cloud fundamentals. Everybody is aware about why Microsoft Azure, right? We will cover that in another session, or I would ask Manish and team to make sure they share some of the previous links, which is already available on our YouTube channel. Guys, am I audible to you all?
Yes, sir, you are.
Yes.
Am I audible to you all?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yeah, sorry, there was some network glitch at my side. So I was mentioning about continuous monitoring and the significance of continuous monitoring in agile world, right? So here, what we have been doing, going customer to customer, we have been talking and educating them about cloud computing, educating them about how Microsoft provides its services, especially in terms of cloud, much better than others by giving a large spectrum of services, giving large spectrum of resources available that people can work with. One more point which I mentioned, I am not sure how much of that was heard. Manish and team, Manish and Rupesh, they can also provide you links of our YouTube channel where you all can go through Cloud Computing Foundation, Azure Foundations. That's a separate session altogether. I don't want to discuss that in this session because of the time constraints. Now, once we have understood the significance of cloud, significance of Microsoft Azure, people would start migrating their applications on Azure. And this is one of the most important areas that everyone would be looking at today. How do I move contents? How do I create resources once it comes to Azure platform, right? So first part over here is migration. Many organizations, I'm not saying they will have not discussed or not thought about other aspects before migration, but like my colleagues mentioned very clearly, the actual things come into play when the rubber meets the road. Otherwise, before that, everything is just planning and a lot of things are assumptions, certain things in head. You must have done some POCs for that, right? So once you have migrated or deployed some of the resources, now you start checking for what are the security features being given by Azure. For physical environment, Microsoft is taking care. What are the other services, security services like Key Vault, encryption services, certificate services, right? How those things are being handled over here? How do we take care of threat protection? Some of these things are very, very important from cloud perspective. And how do I know that which of the source code which I have deployed or which services I have used is not secured, right? So those things you'll be able to see by continuous monitoring. So after applying all the resources, after applying all the features, is there some unwanted data access that will come out via continuous monitoring? Now, once it comes to your resources, if the resource encounters a downtime, right? Do you have a backup strategy for it? Do you have a disaster recovery strategy for it? And just to bring to your notice, even after so much of strictness by number of audit organizations, only 30%, 30, only 30% organizations today have backup and DR solutions or BCDR solutions, right? So there is still a lot of scope over here for people to understand the significance of data protection. Now, once it comes to security and protection, along with that, there are a lot of other aspects in terms of performance, operational efficiency of your resources, which you'll be able to dig out by using continuous monitoring process. But the challenge is, what do I monitor? You need to monitor your application, which is running. Once the user communicates to it, you need to manage the underlying infrastructure on top of which this application is running. You need to check for the network monitor, right? How are these applications running? Which network data packets are being lost? Which data packets are being gathered correctly? Very, very important would be hybrid scenarios, where you are communicating with your on-premises environment, where you are communicating with your underlying resources, how they are working, what are the possibilities there. When you're looking at complex environments, you'll have to gather log information from number of servers that is being provisioned, right? Number of diagnosis needs to be done of these resources, how they are performing, what is going wrong, correct? Believe me once again, when I'm saying it is very easy to put out assumptions saying that cloud is this, cloud is that, and you can do scaling, right? A lot of these things on paper sounds very good, but there are plenty of nuances, plenty of tuning, tweaking that one needs to do as the app developer once you go to cloud, correct? And I'm not saying there are no options. There are lots and lots of options, but we will have to tune it, tweak it, depending upon your observation, depending upon continuous monitoring feedback that you have received. Okay, just give me a moment. While I talk about these resources, it is very crucial that we have certain things in context. I'm sure you are able to see this diagram. What I'm trying to showcase is how a hybrid environment would look like. How you'll have a primary side, how you'll have a secondary side. Correct? And believe me, this is a very, very simple kind of architecture which I'm showing you. So in terms of network monitoring, how the communication will happen within the on-premises environment, how your applications will be running on a cloud platform, how do you perform a disaster recovery solution, right? Whether the network communication is happening correctly or not. So for handling each of these scenarios, you will have to make sure you have a very, very well crafted out diagnostics environment, very well crafted out scenarios for management and monitoring these members. Okay, so when you are configuring these monitoring, what I was talking about is specifying update management for all the virtual machines. If you have past services, how do you take a backup of those resources time and again? How much of automation needs to be done? Now, this is a very, very important part which I would want to stress upon. Now, once it comes to your organization, and when you are looking at something like DevOps and agile processes, believe me, guys, it will not leave you scope for manual operations. Okay, everything over here has to be automated, and please be careful of that. If you leave out chances for manual operations, there will be a big, big challenge over here. Everything has to be automated. Everything has to be scripted. Yes, there could be events. There could be certain manual triggers. I don't see a challenge there. But apart from that, everything else has to be automated. If you are not doing that, you will not be able to achieve the DevOps in real sense. If you look at the last and very, very important pillars of this, which is governance. Right? So who's supposed to enforce these security options, right? Who has exclusions over here? who is supposed to protect these resources and what are the ways and means that we have decided, correct? There has to be appropriate roles that needs to be given to people. There has to be permissions given to respective people, right? And they would know that this is their responsibility to make sure the governance is being specified correctly, right? So while you are doing the migration planning, people also do parallel governance planning. They would create blueprints, they would create set of policies, role-based access control, right? Other security options, all these things will be ready, thought about, planned, phase by phase, how these things will be happening, right? All these decisions have been taken, right? And then starts the implementation. Now, once the implementation is being done, there has to be a, what do you say? It can't be crystal ball gazing. So it has to be what was being planned versus what do we have right now, correct? There are two aspects that you have. And who will tell us that whether whatever was being planned has been achieved or not? That is through monitoring. Right? So I hope this brings out the significance of monitoring to everyone. Let's proceed further. Now the next question will be, Om Prakash, you talked a lot in terms of what is significance of monitoring. What is monitoring all about? Now the question is, how will it happen? How do I implement that? For implementing, there is a complete unified solution given by Microsoft, which is called as Azure Monitor. As part of Azure Monitor, you'll see on the left-hand side, the number of sources that you have, from where you'll get this information, get the data, right? Whereas, whereas on right-hand side, you'll see set of services available. So all these, what you're seeing over here are your services, right? So in terms of integration, you have event hubs, logic apps for responding mechanism, you have alerts and auto scale. So there are series of services available as part of Azure Monitor. But these services and the data which is coming in has to be stored somewhere, right? So even if I have to write queries to my database, I'll have to store that data somewhere. So that data is being stored within two very, very crucial data stores, which is logs and metrics. Metrics specializes in terms of numeric data, whereas logs specializes into verbose and numeric data as well. So if you want only metrics, only numeric information, go for metrics data store. And if you're looking for verbose and numerical both information, exception stack trace, logs, right? Log files that you have, all those will go into log storage. Now, once that data is being stored, you can fetch that information through Metric Explorer, log analytics. You can craft out beautiful diagrams over here in terms of dashboards, views, right? If you feel that some of these components are not showcasing all the contents properly, go for Power BI and you can create beautiful visualizations over there, correct? And when I say beautiful visualizations, I'm definitely saying the amount of data which is being captured is huge, and data is coming from number of sources. So it could be your on-premises environment, it could be your third-party sources, right? Your other hosted applications, it could be AWS, your GCP. So when you have a multi-cloud solution, you have logs gathering everywhere. So get all those logs into a single place and create a beautiful graph out of it, visualization out of it. I don't think it is required to be told to you all. Most of you all who have been working with enterprises, and when you go to any of your within your sites or when you visit your customer sites, there are a lot of television sets which are being, there's no match going on there. The television sets or the screens that you'll see will show a lot of graph saying that this is how the entire process is working, how many servers are up, how many servers are down, right? So by the time everything is green, people are happy, they are working with it, no problem. The moment it shows red, the respective team has to get deployed. They have to figure out what has gone wrong, right? They will find out what is the problem and how do you solve that. And that's where the SLA comes into picture, where they will have to get the system up and running within the specified duration, in the specified timelines that they have promised to the organization. And when I'm saying this, SLAs, this is not just for the underlying infrastructure. It will be for applications, it will be for normal applications, containerized applications, right? Virtual machines. So they will have to take a look at all these members and make sure they revive the system as fast as possible. As far as some of these things are concerned, I have already mentioned about it. I mentioned about the significance of logs and metrics, so I'll skip this and jump on to a very important entity which I have planned for today, is application insights. So as far as application insights is concerned, like I mentioned about significance of capturing data, right? And this data is referred as telemetry. How do I get this information from multiple data sources, like I showed you earlier, and how do I process this information? Now, this telemetry is processed using machine learning solutions behind the scene, right? Don't worry, y'all are not expected to learn machine learning. Yes, if you all want, again, Manish and team, they can help you with machine learning, some of the previous session contents that we have delivered, and my colleague, Mr. Chandrasekhar and Chitra Madam, they have delivered the sessions on machine learning. You can take a look at it. But here, what I'm talking about is Microsoft behind the scene does all these machine learning algorithms for us so that we can leverage the benefits of that when using an application insights environment. Okay. So as a developer or as an infrastructure person, I don't have a skills on machine learning. Correct? So Microsoft will do it for us. They will obviously charge us for that service. And we'll be able to access application insights. Any questions or challenges that we have within our application, those things are displayed over here using graphical representations, and it will be able to solve most of our questions or concerns that we have. If you look at application insights, this is how it works. So if you see AI everywhere, AI over here in these contexts does not represent artificial intelligence. It is actually application insights. So you can have application insights applied onto web pages, client applications. You can use SDK for your web services, right? Within your API layer that you have, there you can use artificial intelligence. You can apply application insights. You can apply your application insights within your background services, again using an SDK, right? So programmatically or through configuration, we can configure number of aspects over here for our environment, right? So any external service communication, SQL communication, SQL or external service, this is where you don't have your application insight running. You don't have application insight running over here, but any communications which are happening, how much time it has taken, has there been any data loss in between, all those information will be captured and you'll be able to see it within your application insights. So application insights basically is a repository of all the telemetry or the diagnostic information of your application within itself and its communication outside. Now, once you have gathered this information, you can create respective alerts over here where you can inform other team members that this is how it is working, something has gone bad, or something is not working as per the expectation. So you can raise alerts for it. Along with that, you can have your Power BI, like I mentioned earlier, the significance of it. You can have your Visual Studio where you can have the profile dump, where you can see what is happening. Remember, we have been working with debug solutions, debug options, right? Here, we are referring about release applications. So there is no debug information over here, but you can download the profile information, see what has gone wrong inside that. and obviously make required corrections to it. You can have continuous import, continuous export to other data sources, right? Like how I said, Log Analytics is a centralized member within Azure. There could be other services that the company is using for processing this information, and there'll be more. There'll be another set of graphs that you would want to create. I will talk about that as I go ahead. So three important things which Application Insights is supposed to do. First is monitor your complete environment. Again, you will have to configure it, how much of information you want to monitor, which details you want to monitor. Guys, please be careful. We are also paying for the amount of data which is being stored, the amount of data which is being processed once it comes to Application Insights. My general observation, which I have seen and I would want to share with you all, whenever you are starting afresh, starting new with the cloud platform, people generally have a tendency to capture every information possible, right? Which reduces as the time moves by. So when you know how the platform performs, what are the challenges or what is the feature that we have, slowly and steadily people would want to remove those diagnostic details or remove those diagnostic settings that they would have done, correct? But in the initial phases, people would want to capture almost every possible information. Now, once you have captured these details, how do you detect what is going wrong? How is it working? Is there any issues anywhere? Along with that, any kind of new sites that you are deploying, new environments or new applications, right? Every organization loves innovation. So anything new that you are trying to do, make sure you detect and diagnose those things, check how it is working effectively, and then build, measure, or learn from it. You can increase the resources, decrease the resources, right? What is the outcome that you have received here? Now, the first thing that I want everybody to do here is look at Application Insights for basic web pages, right? So basic web pages, if you look at, some of the key things that will help you do is observe the metrics over here, capture details within the environment, right? Using JavaScript, check for page load time, check for your AJAX failures, so Anand has a very important question where he says, what is the difference between Azure Monitor and Application Insights? So Anand, I doubt if you have seen the earlier diagram. I'll go to it once again. And this diagram helps us to understand the difference. So here, if you see the Insights section, this is actually Application Insights. So Application Insights is part of Azure Monitor. So Azure Monitor is the complete environment that you are looking at right now, and Application Insights is just one part of it. Does this make sense? Thank you. Let's move ahead. Okay. So if you look at Application Insights for web pages, this is the core significance of the members that we have over here. That is segmented breakdowns by users, pages, right? Which client operating system is being used, the browser version which is being used right now, what is the geographical locations, or any other information that you want to find out. Now, all these details you can get by adding a simple JavaScript into your page, right? like you almost have heard about Google Analytics, right? It will be very similar to that. That's the core purpose of using application insights for your web pages. And this is the code which I was mentioning about. This is the code which I was referring to in the previous slide, right? And this is the details which it captures for you. Now, the only thing that you'll see will change over here would be your instrumentation key. So once you specify the instrumentation key correctly, you'll be able to see the details over here. I don't know the name, just mentions mguest. But not just hold on for some time. We will come to that section as well. I will park this question for now. I'll come to this section a bit later. Okay, so let's go ahead. Let me show you a small demo over here of the existing environment. You all can do it on your own as well. Now for this, what I would recommend is you all can go ahead, create a file over here, right? And within that file, put the code which I'm mentioning about, and nothing to worry. It's a simple HTML content. And the same JavaScript content which I'm talking about. Let me see if I can put it on the chat window. So guys who are attending the session, I think the entire content is being pasted. Just copy this. Create HTML file. No, it's not pasting here. Yes, so I put it on the chat window. Just copy this content. You can add simple HTML over here before it. And if you see, this is what I have done. Just add HTML before that, save with whatever name you want. And the only thing which I need everybody to change would be the instrumentation key. This is the older key which I have. So what I'll do is I'll replace it by a new key. Right? So whenever you create application insights, it gives you back an instrumentation key. Mention the instrumentation key over here. I'll also put it on the chat window so that even everybody who has copied this content uses the instrumentation key within their file. Okay. Now, once you're done with this, just make sure you run this HTML file and you can save it wherever you all want. That's not a problem. You'll just have to make sure you create a new file, paste that script inside that, and put the instrumentation key there. Once you have saved it, let me run it. And I would want to run this from different browsers. So I've write on Edge. I would run it, want to run it on Chrome. I would run it on Internet Explorer. Have Firefox or any other browser, just run it on different set of browsers, refresh it multiple times so that we can see the details over here which are being captured. So once you're done with this, it will take some time, say a minute or two, and will show you all the information in the usage section, number of users, number of sessions that has been initiated, number of events which has been captured, respective user flows based on whichever event you select. So Chrome, Edge, I don't know, somebody is using a firewall. So whoever is using a firewall, it shows undefined, because it is not pushing that information, or it is not allowing the JavaScript to capture the details. This is the older information which I have with my previous application. The current application, it is taking. So this is the one. Can you see this? D:\delivery. So it shows me the folder name. From which folder, wherever I have copied, ran this file from. It shows me all that information. So you can see complete end-to-end transaction details, how and what communication has happened, right? All that telemetry information you'll be able to see over here. I'm not sure how many of you all have done this step as of now. Okay, there's somebody who's using a VPN. I don't know who this person is. But here I can see United States, there is one entry. So either there's a person who's from US or there's a VPN being used over here. Right, so you can get all the user information here. You can get respective session information here. So whatever we spoke about in context of insights, you'll be able to see all the information here. this is from the front end perspective. So from front end, how do they capture all this information? How do they get all the details? This is what I was mentioning about. So if there was any exception, any problems, it'll show me all the details as well. Okay. So I hope everybody is clear with what is the end user information or end user details that we have over here. Let me proceed further. And same thing, what I have done over here can also be done using any app insights resource that you are creating and what information you want to capture from it. Okay. So this was the first section, that is working with HTML components or HTML pages. So right now, whatever we have done was capturing all the information about the end user actions and how does it work. So if you look at your Azure monitor, what Azure monitor actually does is it helps you capture the application monitoring data, your guest OS if you're using virtual machines, your Azure subscription information, your tenant information, your resource diagnostic information. So if you are looking at application content, so apart from the front end services or front end components, if you're looking at the business logic layer or your web server components, you will have to add application monitoring over there. And that's where your App Insights SDK comes into picture, right? That's where you have to make that change. In terms of web pages, this is what we have done right now. Using JavaScript, we have specified our JavaScript content, enable debugging, disable AJAX tracking, right? This will help you to send the telemetry information immediately. Now, there's a question which is being mentioned, and I said I will park this question for later. So if you're looking at console applications, desktop applications, so for desktop applications or web applications, the step will remain same, which means you have to install. And the example which I'm discussing right now is in context of ASP.NET or .NET Core, right? You can do it for Java applications or Node application, because for each of them, you have respective SDK for it. So you can download that SDK, download the respective jar files, download the required JavaScript contents for each application type. In this session, I'm discussing very, very categorically about .NET environment. So from .NET environment perspective, you have to install Microsoft Application Insights, Dependency Collector, right? And once you've done that, you'll have to mention the instrumentation key. Remember, I showed the place from where you can get this instrumentation key, right? So you can use it over here. You'll have to specify applicationinsights.config. So within that configuration file, what all details you want to mention, right? You can do that. Now, within your, you can also do it programmatically by using something called as instrumentation key, which is a property of telemetry configuration. And wherever, once you have configured it, wherever you want to trace certain values or add certain values in tracing, right, you can specify it over there. whatever you mention as track trace will go to your application insights data store. Okay, so you can go ahead, write your content. You can have create from configuration appinsights.config. It will capture all the details from there. And once you have captured that information, you can start specifying what information you want to store over here. So initialize the configuration. So console application for desktop applications, if you see. Desktop application also, you have same initial steps, absolutely no change. Right? Application insights, dependency collector, and add your instrumentation key by using appinsights.config. Like how you have your web.config, similarly, you have over here as appinsights.config. As part of your desktop applications, you can go ahead in the form load method itself. You can mention what is the instrumentation key that you would want, right? And how do you initiate a session over here for each of the users? That will be one of the important aspects once it comes to your resources over here. So if you look at your application insights platforms, this is what I was mentioning about. So you can use your SDK for .NET, Java, your JavaScript resources, Node.js, correct? And if you see the official support that it provides, there are a lot of other technologies which it can connect to. Anyone who's looking at more detailed information about it, just give me a moment. Any detailed information you're looking at, you can go to Azure documentation. As part of look for application insights. And you see, it is one of the important components of DevOps. So this entire documentation is primarily focused on how do you set up these resources? What are the options over here? Right? And you have code-based monitoring for .NET, Java, Node.js, Python. Celebrated from Java background, they can see here how you can enable application insights within Java application using Maven artifacts. I'm not sure why people have this confusion. People say that most of these resources that we have in terms of development is only targeted towards .NET. It's not true. And that's why I wanted to make sure people understand that application insights is available for each of the members or and multiple technologies as well. Let me put this link on the chat window. Vaishnath has a very important. I'm not sure if I'm reading out the name correctly. Sorry for that. Madhav is mentioning it correctly. So once it comes to tracking whether the site is down or whether it is up, that will go into exceptions. So when it is throwing exceptions, the exception, depending upon what is the current exception status, whether it is exception for the application or the unavailability. So whenever you see, say 400 or 404 kind of errors, which means the site itself is not available, that goes into the exception section. So there you can track it. Right. So what I have done is I have shared a link with you all, which showcases all information about how and what will be the options available here in context of application insights. And the most important reason why I have shared it with you all is in terms of different technologies, JavaScript, Python, Node.js, Java, and .NET. For each of them, how do you use application insights? That's the most important aspect, which I want all of you all to go through whenever you'll have time. And this will help you to take your learning to the next level. Let me proceed further. So this was about application insights, application performance over here. Let's go to the next section here. So as part of the data sources, right? Here, as part of your Azure core platform, what data is being captured over here is your diagnostic solutions, your metrics, service health. Now all this information is coming from base Azure. As far as what we are looking at right now, in terms of application contents, the data source over here is application insights. From guest operating system, what you'll be getting is details via diagnostic agents, dependency agents, right? This is more in terms of your underlying operating system or underlying infrastructure that you have, right? This is more in terms of underlying infrastructure that one has. If you look at the monitoring sources for Azure Monitor, right now what we are looking at is this part, which is application insights. Apart from that, there are a number of other sources as well that you see. You can get this information from your Azure Monitor using CLI, using PowerShell, using Portal, right? Even your details within application insights, you can get it via Azure Portal that we are doing right now. And you can get the same information via PowerShell and CLI also. So depending upon how do you want to capture this information? How do you want to showcase this information? So if you look at your application insights, right? If you go to our application insights here, you'll be able to see each of the sessions. Right, so there are 14 sessions by now. And if you go to view more insights, you'll be able to see number of users, number of active sessions, their respective timelines. Can you see over here the load time? The load time will tell you how much time will it take to load a particular page. Right? Show timeline for this user, show timeline for a specific session. All this information you can dig down and you can check over here. And you have number of filter parameters over here. So based on that, you can check which user or which event you want to dig deeper into. So depending upon the timelines, or you can go to each of the sessions over here. For each session, what is the information? Okay, Ashish, does it answer your question? So there are options available, and that is referred as end-to-end transaction details. Here you can find out the telemetry or more details about each refresh which the customer is doing, or refresh in sense the each request that is the user is sending, and how much time is it taken for response. Let's proceed further. So as one of your application insights, what we can do is we can have extensible application performance monitoring, right? You can check for a live application when there are number of people who are requesting the same website, what are the steps which are happening over here, any kind of performance anomalies that you have, right? You can see a complete graph over here. In terms of real world behavior or any kind of custom queries that is being fired, custom queries will be done using KQL, that is Kushlo query language, right? And you can have your metrics visualization for the same. Now, like how we discussed about the HTML page, similarly, the metrics which gets monitored as part of your Azure App Insights, now specifically in terms of the backend tier, that is service tier, your data access layer, right? Your application services there, what it actually checks for is there any kind of request response failure? How much time it is taking to communicate between two tiers, right? In terms of dependency rates, your failure rates, any kind of exceptions which is being seen over here, any kind of aggregations, right? You can analyze these aggregations. Now, if there is certain values given by the user, which is incorrect, right? Certain data which was not able to fetch and reaches an exception, you can see all that information in at a single place. That is what is the advantage that we get once we come to application insights. Some of these aspects we already have mentioned, that is asynchronous JavaScript and XML calls, right? Working with performance counters. Now, this is a very important aspect. From a server's perspective, see, I'm not saying we should be tightly glued on to the operating system and finding out details, but that's the core infrastructure on which your environment is running. So you have to check for counters in terms of CPU usage, memory usage. Like I mentioned earlier, if I have to tweak or tune certain things, where is the mistake? I have to know that, right? So is that some problem with my application code? Is that an issue? So I can tweak the code. If there's some issue as far as the infrastructure is concerned, say for example, the application is running absolutely fine till 1000 requests. The moment it goes from 1000 to 5000 or 1000 to 2000, that's where the latency increases, which means my code is not a problem. The infrastructure is not supporting the new set of requests because the machine CPU percentage or CPU utilization is already 80%. Are we getting it? So in these kind of scenarios, the conclusion that we will come to is we will have to increase the number of machines, increase the number of app service instances that we have behind the scene. That's why diagnosing the underlying platform is equally important, like how we're diagnosing the application. So if you're running Docker applications or running your ACR components or ACI components, right? Azure container instances, right? So within Azure container instances, how much resources are being consumed right now? If I go back to Azure Monitor, if you look at Azure Monitor, there are plenty of insights which are available here. Virtual machine insights, container insights, right? Storage and backup insights. So there's insights available for anything and everything that you want over here. Currently, what we are looking at is application insights, which is one of the components of Azure Monitor. So it says this is where it is being configured. And these are the information here. Another very important thing over here, which I want everybody to understand, is the application map. So whenever your application is communicating with a number of other resources, if you recall the previous diagram where I mentioned about the key resources, that is your database or your API service, API layer, data access layer, right? So we need to make sure we have a tool which can go to each of these components, check for how this interactions or invocations are happening. And then we'll be able to figure out how much latency or how much time is taken to connect to the Azure account, to app service, right? To respective third party APIs. Right? So where is that? So if you are able to dig out that details, we'll be able to solve that problem faster. We'll be able to resolve that issue much faster. Otherwise, we'll be looking at a wrong place and the error is at somewhere else also. Is at some other place. So just to showcase map insights which I have created. Right? There is a web application here, which is OMP Synergetics web app. Right, so you can see the details over here. So where are people requesting from? These are all my requests which I have done. Which browser has been used? Can you see this? So every request which has come over here, for each request, I can see the information.
Just a question here.
Tell me.
Yeah, so how we can find out the user flows and the most visited pages, as well as the pages which had longer duration of, you know, time spent on. Mm-hmm.
I'll come to that section a bit later. Let me first complete off with this part. That is the application app. It's not showing the web application which I have created. It is still taking me to the. Because this web app which I'm referring to, this web app has a database connectivity. Let me go to that app service itself. This is my app service. Okay, I'm not sure who asked that question. That was a very good question. Now, once it comes to how many pages have been, which pages have been viewed the most. Now that information you can find out from the KQL. Remember I mentioned about push to query language. And lot of other details are available here itself. Let me show that as well. It's taking slightly longer because I have taken a shared tier. Let me increase the configuration over here. And this is the advantage that I have for my Apple's plan. So I have a complete website over here. Okay, so if I go to App Insights, can I see this? So the complete graph that you'll see over here, how many request counts have been there? Can you see this? Which pages have been viewed for how many times? Does this answer the question?
Right.
Whichever APIs have been invoked for number of times. This is where you get that details under the performance section. Now it is getting. This is what I was looking for. I don't know why. I have actually two things here. One is the entire web application with SQL database connectivity. And the another one that I have is the new file which I just created, a single HTML file. So this is what I was looking for. So here, if you see, the Synergetics web application is talking to the underlying data store, which is Parts Unlimited. Right, so I can get that information here. How much time does it take to connect to the database? And I should also see communication details here under application map. Yeah, this is what I was looking for. Let it load. So what I showed you in the diagram is actually the same thing which is happening here. So how much time does the web application take to connect to data store, slowest call, fastest call, how much the time duration it is taking. So is database communication an issue? Which means I have to not just enhance the S2 for web server. I have to also move it from serverless to server oriented. Right, so those details I'll have to take care. it takes 355 milliseconds right now. Right? And this is the application which I have. Any kind of exceptions or
we can see the time taken for the particular SQL query also, correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
So I showed you right now. So if you see
this. That's right. Correct.
So 355 milliseconds is the time taken for database query.
Okay.
You can have your complete profiler over here. Right. So you have to profile this application communication. You want to create specific triggers over here. Now, how many instances do I have right now? Say, like I told, gave you an example, I may have for an application where I'm getting too many requests, right? I may be getting too many requests over here. So for that, what I can do is I can specify a number of instances. So how many instances do I have right now? Because when I configure auto scaling, so increase in number of requests, I will create more number of instances. So right now I have only one instance currently. Right? So how is my server running? What is the request count over here? Any dependencies which I have with that machine? Okay. How many communications have been done as of now? Talking to master database, talking to parser limited database. Now, one request which I have all of y'all, let me put this on the chat window. Can you all send a request to this website? Everyone, just go to this website or go to the URL, just refresh it multiple times. Now, why am I asking you all to do that? So that I can show you the live metrics. So depending upon the number of hits which I'm receiving, I will be able to show you the live metrics over here. Okay. Thank you very much, everyone. So I can see some live tracking happening over here. So how much is the committed memory, total CPU utilization? So more number of times you'll refresh. See, now it is going six. This is the request rate which is there. Okay, so everyone, if you are on that website, go to breaks and just go to the URL, category ID is equal to 11. Just click on breaks, change the URL manually, category ID is equal to 11. See, the moment I did it, it says there's a failure and there's an exception which has been raised in the background. Are you getting it? So not just success, but even failure, if it is there, it will start tracking that. So any problems in viewing the website, any problems in showcasing of the content, all these things you can see over here. How much is the total CPU utilization, failed request rates, how much is total CPU utilization, so I hope most of your questions are being answered with this. Now, the fun part over here I want to explain to everybody is, how did I configure all these things? So just give me some time so that I can explain that. Let's proceed further. So if you look at the entire process which I have followed over here, correct? Which even y'all should be able to replicate. So first thing which I have done is I have taken a resource over here. As part of my Azure DevOps environment. Now within this DevOps environment, whatever code you want to publish over here, I'm not getting into that area. I'm getting something specifics only in context of application insights. So here, if you see, I have applicationinsights.config. Right. So within applicationinsights.config. Sorry, not seeing an option to zoom in. Okay, so here, as part of the slides which I have shown, Windows Server performance counter, unhandled exception, right? Request tracking telemetry module. So all this information is part of your applicationinsights.config. This has already been given to you. Along with this, we'll have to go to web.config. And within web.config, we will have to mention within web.config, you have to mention the instrumentation key. Obviously, other connection string to your database or other services that you have that you have to mention by default. The additional member that one has to put over here along with your applicationinsights.config would be the instrumentation key, right? And this instrumentation key 8F52D is the same thing that we have used for our HTML page. So whether it is your HTML page or your web application or your services that you are creating, your instrumentation key will remain consistent. Okay, so I hope that makes sense for everyone. That's the first thing that you have to do as part of your code is concerned. Now, second important member over here that you have over here is your pipelines. Right, so as far as pipeline is concerned, what I have done over here is, as part of my release pipeline, in the variable section, I have already specified what are the details of this. So what will be the hosting plan, resource group name, right? The server, database server which I'm using, the web application where I want to deploy this. So all this mapping over here is done as part of the release pipeline. And that gives me an advantage of pushing these contents or creating these resources onto my cloud environment. So once this gets deployed successfully, and during deployment, what it will do is it will automatically publish the contents, which includes application insights configuration. That's one. And second, that it helps me achieve over here is help me associate the database with my web application. Along with it shows all the application insights over here. Okay, so one important change I showed you about was repos, where you have to go and make change in the code. Second is in the release pipeline. The third and very, very important one, which I can't afford to miss out. When you go to your web application, so I showed you about app insights, what are the options available here. Right, I showed you those details. Along with this, if you go to your web application, even within your web application, you have something called as application insights here. when you go to your application insights, here you'll be able to enable application insights. That's the first and very important thing. If you move down, depending upon what kind of application that you are creating, is it a .NET application, .NET core application, Node, Java, Python, what type of application you are creating, you have to go and turn on these members, right? So any kind of SQL commands which is executed, I want to get information on that. Local variables, snapshot, debugger, I want information about that. I would want profiling information of your database. Correct? So whatever communications are happening, your database profiling, your web application profiling, all these resources we will have to enable here. Same thing holds true with .NET as well. So if you have any insights over here, you can go and apply that. I don't have a Node.js or Java application right now. If I had, I can go and enable these components over here. So please be careful in terms of steps. So step one, like I said, in your web application, we need to make sure that we have added required details within our code. That's the first part. Second part is during pipelines, and especially your release pipeline, mention appropriate details of the web application. Third step, as part of your web application, make sure we have configured application insights. There are three very, very important sections over here. Let me proceed further. So whenever you are looking at any complex application, right? Any of the complex applications, there will be number of components, number of resources that we have, like for multi-tier applications, you'll have your presentation tier, your services tier, your business logic layer, data access layer, right? Similarly, once it comes to microservices, in terms of microservices, there are additional set of components over here where you'll have your shipping component, your billing component, right? How these components are interacting with each other, even that we need to find out. Like how I showed you, the database communication, right? Similarly, you need to have insights for your container communications. Now that information, that container insights is another component that you all can utilize, especially when you are using something like AKS, Azure Kubernetes Services. Now, if you see each of these components, they can be separate. There can be a separate app insights instrumentation key. If you want to capture this information separately, you can have different instrumentation keys for it, right? So in that case, what will happen is this will give you a pretty clean kind of environment, like how it happened for me, right? If y'all saw it, right? So the moment I refreshed it, it started capturing the recent information from the HTML page rather than my index page, which was there for my web application. Right, so just to avoid these kind of confusion, you can create different App Insight instances and have respective instrumentation keys mapping to them. In terms of dashboards over here, there are plenty of pre-existing dashboards which is being given to you, right? So I don't think that should be a problem. Microsoft has made sure they provide maximum details that you have within the same platform, within the same resource itself. But still, there will be a lot of other requirements that people have, and they would say, Om Prakash, if we can create something additional, like one of my friends said, yeah, Ashish, that can I use a KQL query over here? Yes, why not? You can write your KQL queries And through that KQL queries, you can create, you can capture whatever attributes or whatever properties you want apart from which is being shown by default, right? So you can get those details. You have something called as workbooks over here, right? So using workbooks, you can create beautiful diagrams over here and you can work with it. Along with that, you can use your log analytics, right? Even using log analytics, you can do that. And within log analytics, you have large number of pre-existing or pre-created queries which you can work with. I doubt if this is available anymore. This is the older one. This is again log analytics, but this is not the existing one. This is the older one. New one is this part, where you can create it using a workbook and pin it on your Azure dashboard. So you can have respective workbooks over here where you can check for the time spent by the user on a specific page, right? You can have analysis of page views as well. You decide how do you to create those components and work with it. Just give me a moment. Where do I have it? Let me show that to y'all. So under App Insights, let's go to the log section. Within log section, I'm not sure how many of them will run right now because it takes time to capture information within log analytics. And right now I don't have a predefined scope over here, right? So it may take some time to push that data here. So this is basically your KQL queries. Audit logs, Azure metrics, incoming requests. So what I would recommend is you can create your App Insights. You can check for the KQL queries from here. Doing some error with the syntax. We'll have to create a workspace over here. Or even if you go to the documentation, you'll find sample KQL queries for each of these resources. There are two ways of accessing this information. One is using your SDK, that's one. And second is using KQL queries. Some of these things I have already showed you, which is available via portal. From log analytics, I'm not sure why this is giving error, because the where clause is correct over here. Right, so these are a few of the show queries that you can see. Ashish, does it make sense? Another very good question from Ashish. How much old logs or telemetry is stored in App Insights? See, app. I don't think that's the right question, because when we started with the entire session, I clearly told that App Insights does not store anything. The storage is inside metrics and log data store. So if you recall that architecture, that question is already answered. App Insights is only is the backend of how you can show that information, but it does not store anything. So I don't think that's a valid question. Maybe you have joined late, no problem with that. Data store, nothing happens inside App Insights. Data store is your log analytics, your log data stores and metrics data store. Sorry guys, I'm running short on time. Let me move ahead. So this is one set of resources which you have. Right? Second details that we second way of showcasing this information would be Power BI. Right? So using this Power BI details, Power BI environment, you can have your metrics over here and you can have different type of graphs. Like somebody was asking, how do you know where these requests are coming from? Right? So you can have network usage by location, data activity or various requests coming from various regions. So you can create your own custom components as well as part of your Power BI. Now, another important question that could be is, Om Prakash, you mentioned about sending or exporting this data outside. So what are the other tools similar to App Insights which will consume this data? So you have other modern tools like ELK, if you have used that. You have AppDynamics, you have Datadog. Right? You have your AKS dashboard, right? So App Insights is not the only way of capturing this insights information, right? So there are a number of other members as well, number of other options that you have for monitoring. So my recommendation would be you can use number of other resources, number of other tools, check which one gives you maximum set of benefits. From my experience, I'm telling you, App Insights gives you maximum details that you would want, and it is available for developers. It is available for IT, infrastructure team, right? They can also work with it. It is backed up by the so you don't have to purchase licenses or any third party kind of tools, right? So all these things are being taken care of by Microsoft. As far as App Insights is concerned, there is no cost associated with it. The cost basically will be the cost over here is actually for the amount of data that you are storing, which is part of your log analytics data store. For App Insights, independent resource, if you see, there's no much cost for it. Right? So if you are looking at some other tools that you have and the different set of licenses or any kind of infrastructure required for it, those kind of challenges is automatically being addressed when you're looking at App Insights. Right? You have another tool called as Grafana as well, which is a paid tool specialized for log analytics, specialized for analytics of number of resources from an infrastructure perspective. So say, for example, an organization already has purchased Grafana, right? In that case, what I would recommend is, and you already have a license for it. In that case, what I would recommend is push your App Insights contents or App Insights log contents with Grafana, and there you can show all these details. But if you don't have any such licensed products or licensed tools for doing it, no issues. You can use Power BI. You can use your workbooks available within Azure. You can use log analytics graphs. You can use Azure Metrics over here. So there are number of pre-existing options within Azure itself, so that you don't have to go out for any kind of any such tools. With SDK with you, what you can also do is you can say, okay, I don't want to go for Power BI. I don't want to purchase third-party licenses. I want to build a custom solution. No problem. You can do that. So with all the data available, what you want to plot on the x-axis, what do you want to plot on the y-axis, how do you want to create multiple graphs over here, you can build your own custom application on top of this data. Absolutely fine. Please be careful. There'll be a significant engineering which will be required for it. If you have a good team which can do the data visualization for you, creation of resources for you, please go ahead. Okay. Lot of organizations also have some of the ticketing systems. So if there is any challenges or any issues being raised, right, I would want to send that feedback. I want to send that details to other teams so that they can act on it, which is also referred as ITSM. So Microsoft provides ITSM as a connector. Through that, you can connect or send this information to other applications. And those applications will go and those ticketing systems will go and send it to a right team within the organization who would finally go and resolve the problem. Like I said earlier, there could be a server issue, there could be a browser issue. There are older browser versions on the client machines. Why it is giving a problem? Like say, for example, Internet Explorer is being expired today, right? So it has to the operations team has to make sure that everybody has the latest Chrome or latest Edge browser, right? So it can raise the tickets to the required team, and they will do the required changes on the underlying systems. Okay, so I'm sure that I could not cover a lot of other details which I would want to do in the required depth, but whatever is being covered, does it give you all a quick kickstart in an understanding in terms of what is Azure App Insights and how we can work with it in context of DevOps, in terms of simple web pages, database integration? Because that is what I was focusing on. Ashish, a very good question. Let me answer that. So Ashish, any questions you have in terms of pricing? And for any of the Azure services, the best place which I would recommend is this section. So go to azure.microsoft.com, go to Azure pricing, and for our current requirement, we should go to management. Within management, here you should see log analytics. No, I'm not seeing it. Let me check for log analytics over here. Okay, so if you go to Azure Monitor, what it Microsoft charges for is log analytics. So depending upon which region you want to look for, how much is the data ingestion there? Based on that, you'll have your pricing. Around 200 rupees per GB. But I still feel that it is even one filling up 1 GB of data per day, depending up, obviously, it will also depend upon how large is your environment, right? Filling up 4 GB, 1 GB of data, it's pretty huge, especially from a log content perspective, because log content actually is in KBs at times. Ashish, does it answer your question? So data retention, you decide till what time you want to retain the data. So it's 10 rupees per GB per month. Thank you very much for your questions. That really made the session interactive.
Om Prakash, can I ask one question?
Please go ahead.
Yeah. So now if I have one web application and I'm using IIS to host that application, no doubt I am not using any other Azure services, only I'm using Azure infrastructure, like just getting a CPU and all. But on that cases, if I want to use Azure Insight, and do App I need Insights. To create App Insight? Yes, App Insight and application map. Can I also use that, or I have to use Azure, you know, application services only?
Not at all. You can only go and see, you have a web application hosted on a virtual machine. Go ahead, create a Azure App Insights service and use the instrumentation key within your web application. That's it.
Oh, perfect. Good.
No, thanks. There is no dependency that for using Azure App Insights, you must have a app service, Azure App Service or App Service plan. It's not a compulsion.
Okay. Thanks.
No problem. So thank you very much, everyone.
Hey, one quick question.
Sure, Ashish. I have 2 minutes more. Go ahead.
There is a web application.
Yes.
It's hosted on an Azure VM. And there is another database which is hosted on another Azure VM, right?
No problem. So
now, if you're putting this, applying Azure monitoring, like on the application, and or maybe now how do we know if the problem is maybe the VM on which the database is hosted, that is down, right? Not responding. So now we are going to get 3 alerts by App Insights or 1, like from web application or database or that infra.
It'll give you one exception. In that one exception, if you dig down, see what you are monitoring. You're monitoring a web application, right? Correct. So that will, because you can't monitor a database through App Insights. Remember a diagram? So you are monitoring your web application. Your web application will tell, boss, I had a problem connected to the database. So now you go to that exception, dig deeper. It says the server is not responding.
Okay.
So it'll give you one alert or one exception message.
So if we need to monitor VM as well, means that won't be done that can be done through App Insight, right?
No. There is something called as VM Insights. App VM. Insights number, I'll show you once again.
Because
there are a number of insights. App Insights is just one of them. If I go back to Azure Monitor, I showed you a complete series of insights. App Insights is just one of them. You see this?
Yeah.
So you have insights of virtual machines, containers, network, storage account. All this is insights. Application Insight is one of the components of Azure Monitor Insights.
Okay.
And this is what I was talking about right now.
Okay.
I did not even touch upon virtual machine insights. It's a separate component altogether.
Okay. Can I ask a question? If we are monitoring the virtual machine with this virtual machine insight and application to our App Insight, and this related to same, you know, if we take the same scenario where that database is down, in this case, we will be getting 2 alerts or 1 alert?
You'll get 2 alerts, one by VM Insights and one by App Insights. And using your KQL, you'll have to connect to both these data stores and get the data from there.
Okay, that is possible through KQL. That was basically...
Yes, that's possible through KQL.
Okay, thank you.
KQL can query both the data stores, but they are two different data stores behind the scene. Or I would say 2 tables inside the same database, like that. Okay.
Right. So have you heard about something called event correlation?
Yes, I have heard about it.
So in this scenario, can we apply that? Like instead of having 2 alerts, we can basically have one alert.
It's if you are creating your own custom application or you are managing this using KQL, it's up to you. How do you want to correlate that? Azure by default is not correlated.
Okay.
For Azure, it will be two events.
Got it. Basically, Dynatrace has that. It's another monitoring tool, which has that capability. So I was trying to understand if Azure provides that.
From my knowledge, as of now, I don't think it's there. But I will still check for it. If I can have application correlation here.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you. Manish, Rupesh, are you all there?
Yes, sir.
Can you please put up our YouTube channel link over here?
Yes, sir. We have already shared, but again, I'm going to share. So few announcements I want to make. So if you are done with the session, so I'll continue.
I'm done. Yeah.
From here. Okay. So
hello, I have a quick question.
Yeah.
Sorry to interrupt you in between. This is Sanjay here.
Let Rupesh complete. Sanjay, just give him a minute. Yeah, Rupesh, please go ahead.
No, so it will be a closure. So before that, if you could just answer to Sanjay's question so quickly.
No problem. Thanks a lot. Yes, Sanjay, please go ahead. Sanjay? Hello? Yes, Sanjay, go ahead with your question.
I have a question on the merits and demerits of Azure.
There's no time right now for that. I think that link which Rupesh shares on AZ 900 sessions which we have done, that has all these information, Sanjay. Yeah, Rupesh, please go ahead.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. So first of all, I want to thank you, sir, for the wonderful session on continuous monitoring with Application Insights. And thank you everyone for joining us for the webinar. So as sir said, we have already uploaded various past sessions on our YouTube channel. So any particular topic you have any question about, you can just visit our YouTube channel. I'll be sharing all the links in the chat box while communicating to you right now. So I just want everyone's 2 minutes. Just give me a moment. I'll be just sharing my screen for a moment. So I'll be real quick here. I hope my screen is visible to all, right? So this is our upcoming webinar calendar. Okay, so we have various topics that has been placed for the future. So we have two series simultaneously we are running. One is emerging technology webinar series and other is certification series. So today we actually have two webinars. So after this, we'll be having a next session based on PL 900. So anyone who's interested in that, in the certification webinar, you can just join us. I'll be sharing the attendee link for that. So at start, we have announced our upcoming emerging technology webinars. The technology will be Blade Framework and the other will be Jakarta EE9. So we'll be sharing registration links for both the webinars. Anyone who's interested in these technologies, they can register for that. So you can follow us on various YouTube channels to get the timely updates. Guys, your feedback is very important to us as we have time restrictions. So we have kept a special section in the feedback where you can put your comment and put your questions and we'll try to give the answers to you. So please do fill your feedback form. All the links will be shared. And yes, you can follow us on the social media once again. So thank you so much once again, everyone, for attending the webinar. All the links I'll share in the chat box. Please do check and then leave. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your wonderful session.
I have just shared the next webinar's attendee link. If you guys are interested to attend this session, the session will be the speaker for the session is Om Prakash sir only, so you can join us.
The timing of the session?
It will be starting at 2:30.
Okay.
Yeah. So I'll be sharing the YouTube channel link. You can follow us. You can subscribe for this channel.
The PL900 session, is it?
Yeah. The topic is mentioned. And the session is based on PL900. So I have also shared my number. If anyone is interested to inquire anything related to technology trainings or Microsoft certification training, they can just contact me on WhatsApp. They can ping me. So our next webinars registration, I'll be sharing the details. One second. So the session will be in the morning, conducted on weekends, so you can register yourself. And the feedback form, once again, I'm sharing. So do share your feedback, guys. It is important to us, and you can ask your questions even in the section of comment. You can put that. Thank you so much once again from my side. Have a great weekend, everyone. Thank you.